So he will, Ihor Makulchik is a student here, and he will speak about percolation transitions in interacting many-body flatband systems. So please, you can
Hello, can you see my slides, right?
Yeah.
Yes, hello. Yes, I'm Ihor Makulchik. I will be talking about this project we did with Alexei and Sergei, who you already know, and Carlo Danieli, who is now a researcher in Max Planck in Dresden, and he will be giving a talk tomorrow on a very related topic, but let me start. So, yeah, flatbands. Generally, they emerge in certain fine-tuned classes of systems. Even within this fine-tuned manifolds, you can select even more fine-tuned examples with all bands being flat. And in such systems, typically all the eigenstates are compact localized states, and there is no transport. So this we all know, but recently my collaborators showed that you can add interactions, many-body interactions to flatband systems, and additionally fine-tune them in such a way that certain localization is still preserved. So let's consider this model from the paper by my collaborators. Consider Hamiltonian, we will consider fermions, but it can be easily generalized for bosons with two parts, single particle and interaction. Single particle is a sum over unit cells, so L is a unit cell index, and C's are vectors of annihilation operators, and that this single particle part consists only of hoppings and energies inside unit cells. So single particle part is a flat band part where particles cannot move between unit cells. And interaction consists of a network of density-density terms that connect only sites between unit cells. So this tensor J, it encodes weights, but generally you can have an arbitrary connectivity through this indices L of density by density-density interactions. And we can immediately see that in this system by construction, particle transport is impossible. Density-density interaction doesn't move particles, and a single particle part is flat band, so okay, no particle movement. So the number of fermions per each unit cell is constant. Here's a simple example, same thing, but just for two sites per unit cell in a 1D chain, you can see the hoppings here vertically and interactions. And while on this basis, this seems kind of trivial, and it is obvious that there is no particle transport. This is only because of the representation. There are a number of other representations where this will look like a normal Hamiltonian, and just from looking at it, you will have no idea there is this flat band localization, many body flat band localization happening. So, okay, we know that if we, and it is explicit in this basis that there is no particle transport, but what happens with the heat transport, for example, or generally what happens with the transport of other values, so information transport? So let's start answering this question for the same 1D, two sites per unit cell system. And one, what can we say immediately? So yeah, this encoding is, these are unit cells, and sites can be empty or occupied, and this is color coded. There will be some sites, most configurations, unit cells, sorry, with either zero on the maximum, which is two now, number of fermions there. And such unit cells, they have 0 degrees of freedom. So they cannot move anything, no heat, no nothing through them. So we call them blocking unit cells. And in 1D, naturally, that if you consider an arbitrary configuration of these fermions, sooner or later in a long enough chain, you will find one unit, blocking unit cell that completely cuts the system in two. So the relative number of conducting channels, so we call them the conducting or connecting subspaces of the complete Hilbert space, is exponentially small. What happens in conducting islands, these islands with one ferment for each unit cell? Well, it can be mapped on spins, and using Jordan-Wigner transformation, we can show that this model maps exactly on the transverse field Eisen spin chain, which is known to be ballistically conducting, but still the relative role of these subsystems in the whole large system is exponentially small, so there is no conductivity. A little bit more complicated, but still 1D, three sides per unit cells. And general situation is the same. So if there is three or zero fermions per unit cell, this unit cell is blocking. So again, exponentially a large number of subspaces or channels, as we call them, non-conducting and blocking. There is still, it's still possible to map the system onto spin chain. So I is the number of fermions per unit cell, the integral of motion, and both for one and two fermions per unit cell, it's possible to map those onto spin ones. But now we already have emergent disorder because spins that come from one and two fermions a different spin. So due to this microscopic number of integrals of motion, we get this spontaneous break of symmetry and emergence of disorder. What happens in 2D? So now this is these are two again, channels or configurations of the integrals of motion, and the color code is now for unit cells, not for sites as before. It's blue being conducting and yellow being blocking, and again, there are possibly two configurations, two types of configurations, either conducting, so connecting left to right, or blocking. But what is the relative number of balls? And here, many of you, I think, now understand why I had this word percolation in the title. So let me recall just some basic things, just in case. So what is percolation and what are percolations and percolation theory? So consider, for example, a square lattice and with a certain probability place or remove a site on this lattice. And then ask a question, when in thermodynamical limit, this lattice will be connecting, for example, top to bottom or left to right. And then there is always a critical probability such that below it, there are no, well, almost no conducting or percolating clusters, and above it, all of them are. And this is basically what we can have here. So start sampling randomly configurations of the fermions, and in thermodynamical limit, we get exact mapping of the geometric structure on the standard percolation theory. So this expression, it shows the connection between our control parameter, which is Phelan fraction, and critical probability from percolation theory, with the new being the number of sites per unit cell. So yeah, we can easily find the Phelan fraction knowing the results for any given network from percolation theory, and say that below this critical Phelan fraction, asymptotically no connecting state in the whole connecting subspaces in the whole Hilbert space, and that conductivity of anything is impossible. And above it, almost all subspaces are connecting, so it is possible. And this is a very beautiful result in the sense that it's very universal. So remember, I didn't really clarify anything about the Hamiltonian other than geometry. So there is nothing about specific values of hoppings of interactions and such. Just the geometry, the lattice of interactions fully defines these transitions. But okay, we know that transport is impossible due to just geometric geometric properties in one region. But what about other region? Transport is possible, but will it actually happen? And this is now problematic because, as I showed for three sides per unit cell example, there is an emergent disorder. There are actually several emergent disorders here. One is, yes, this effective interactions of spins, or just, yeah, different spins, spins with different origins emergent. But then for more than three sides per unit cell, actually we'll be getting different spins to the system. So spin two will and spin three will be interacting, adding additional disorder. And generally, the structure of these percolation clusters where conductivity will have to take place, it is quite disordered. This is a complicated fractal structure with a number of dead ends. It is something that was already studied for single particles and called quantum percolation. So this is an additional hindering, potential hindering factor for conductivity, at least in low dimensions. So coming to the conclusion, yeah, we show that there exists a class of transitions in the geometrical level in Hilbert spaces in fine-tuned many-body localized so-called systems, so many-body systems based on flat bands and certain semi-fine-tuned interactions, and the bounds for these transitions are very universal and don't depend on many particularities of the particular Hamiltonian. But actual transport in this conducting from the geometrical standpoint regimes can still be suppressed heavily by effective disorder emerging from the macroscopic number of degrees of freedom. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the nice talk. Yeah, one cannot clap. So are there any questions? No questions, or so there don't seem to be any questions.
Or there is a question. I see.
Yeah, there's one by Christian Morfonio. So please.
Yes. Thanks for the nice shot, but nice talk. Yeah, I just wanted just to clarify you. This percolation clustering or landscape, does each pattern, so to say, correspond to one specific many-body eigenstate then of the model?
No. So consider, for example, this. Consider this example. Here we show basically a basis state with specific fermions being in specific locations.
A Fock state.
Fock state. But this is one of the basis states of a subspace that correspond to the fixed values for the integrals of motion. So if we fix one fermion here, one here, zero here, one here, and so on, we have a subspace of the whole Hilbert space because those integrals of motion, they spawn a subspace that is not connected, it's just factorized from all other states. So we call these subspaces channels. So these clusters will not be a single eigenstate because it is, you also cannot really talk about transport in terms of a single eigenstate. Those are subspaces where you can discuss transport.
I see. And the isolated system will stay in that channel because of the integral of motion.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. So any further questions? So there's time for one more question, or so it doesn't seem to be the case. So then let's thank Ihor again. So